What's going on? It's Kelsey11 here, and this is Madden 25 on Xbox 360. And I actually got a few people asking me to play this game or show some videos of it, so I'm going to do it. The good thing about football games is the seasons are only 16 games long, unless you're in the playoffs, of course, which is nice. It's not like some of the other ones where those seasons take forever. So let's get going. We're going to do a franchise. This video is going to be long because I'm going to create the franchise and I really like to get a game into, but I want to show how it all works for anybody who doesn't know. So I guess we'll do offline. I don't know if there's a difference between online and offline. We're going to import our custom roster, which should be the one I just downloaded. I'll check on the Bears to make sure it's right when I'm done with this. But it should be the proper one. Okay, so we could be a player and just be the player. We could be a coach, control the team, or we could be an owner. I actually want to try the owner stuff because that's pretty cool what they did here with this, I believe. So we have a game face of my ugly mug. We'll be in here. There he is. Now, as an owner, we can be a former player, which gives us a legacy score and a higher roster happiness. Since we're a player, the players like us more. But we have less money and less happiness with money, I guess that means. I don't know what that means. We could be a lifelong fan, which gives us a boost with the fans and a success happiness, but we start with less money and a pop and population happiness is less. Pop happiness, I guess? Okay. Or we could be a financial mogul, where we start with a lot more money and money happiness, no legacy score, and less player happiness. Players don't like the rich people. So I'd like to try to be, maybe I was thinking about a former fan and the people like us more. Yeah, or I mean a former player. Yeah, let's go with the former player route. Okay, and we will be the Bears because I am a Bears fan. Look at my hair. I don't think you can change your hair in this, which is crazy because my dude looks, I think he's gonna look completely freaked out. Alright, so let's go with my formal name. If I was a coach, I would be Joseph. I wouldn't be Joey or Joe. Alright, and then we'll throw our real name. My name in here. The Italian coach. I don't know how many Italian coaches are in football overall. I mean, there's a few, obviously. I'm a big dude, so I'm gonna be a big dude. I could go with the medium build, but we're gonna go big time. We're gonna go big. We're going large. We can do the t-shirt. Oh my god, that's huge. Or we could go the polo look. That's a little, that's cool. Or the vest. Well, let's do the vest. That's sharp. Alright, we're going vest. Suit's a little too formal, even though I would actually like to. Okay, sailor cap on, skill level, go all pro, play style, game flow. I'm going to do game flow, where it means you just basically run the plays the coordinator is calling. The one reason I like to do that is because, or else I end up seeming to call in a lot of the same plays, because once you find plays that work, you start using them all the time. We'll do weekly player progression. I'm probably going to sim quite a bit of some of this stuff, though. Injuries on, I'm gonna take injuries off for the preseason because I'm gonna sim preseason. And I don't want like Cutler getting hurt the preseason while I'm simming it. I don't want to do that. Okay. Relocation settings. League type all strafe on. Okay. Pre-snap coaching tips. Okay. Heat seeker. Actually like that stuff. Switch assists on. That's fine. No, we'll turn that off. Full roster on, free agents at minimum players. Let's find resign players off. I'll resign my own players, thank you. And you know what, I'm gonna put progress players on. They'll automatically progress your players, that's fine. Sign off season free agents off, I'll do that. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna start career. So this is gonna be a longer video. I really wanna get a game in here, but I'd like to kind of go over and show how this all works. So we can start our offline league. We have news here going through the murder of a new owner in Chicago with terrible hair. And the guys on the right are like tweeting, like Adam Schefter and Skip Bayless, who are actual people. Mike Hill, Trey Wingo, you know, ESPN guys. and stuff. So they actually tweet, you know, Scalzetti would have some challenges, taking over original franchises, a big responsibility. My dude looks like a zombie. Look at his eyes. Oh my god. So, yeah. We can start our league.
Hi everybody, I'm Trey Wingo, and this
he talks about owner mode. So this is what I like about this new mode, which is very cool to me, is we're the 14th team value in the league out of 32. But we have all the stuff that we can mess with. We can mess with finances as the owner. We can mess with ticket prices for each part of the place. On the right are fans who are tweeting in and they complain or whatever. On the left is our advisor. So the fans like the tickets, actually. They're pretty cheap, which is good. We have merchandise that we can actually specifically change, which is pretty awesome at this hat. I mean, all this stuff, we can do whatever we want with jerseys, memorabilia. They actually don't like, the fans don't like the fact that these are so expensive, but he says that they're selling okay. Then we can do our own concession stands. We can upgrade them. We're at a 3-star, we can upgrade to a 4 and a 5 once we unlock it in the stadium screen. Like coffee, hot dogs, nachos. Of course, we got deep dish pizza in Chicago and Italian beef and the Lake Michigan fish taco for $6. That's actually decent value. That is a decent value for a game. And then we have our team revenue here, which goes over everything else. The more home games, actually, on home games is where we make our money, because we're going to sell tickets and all our revenue. On away games, we just pay players, so we lose money there. Stadium, we can alter all the stadium stuff. We can upgrade it. We have a 40 rating. It's 10 years old. Soldier Field is not the greatest stadium, even though I still love it because it is Soldier Field. Our parking is at 88. We can renovate for 10 million, you know, or upgrade it. We can renovate for, you know, all this stuff. The team stores, the fan zone, the bathrooms. The bathrooms have a horrible rating. I don't know where that picture's from. It's definitely not from Soldier Field, because I've been to Soldier Field bathrooms. They don't look like that. We can upgrade our concessions. We can upgrade our seats. All this stuff. We can end up putting money in once we get enough to do it. Right now, we only got 5 million, so we ain't upgrading nothing. Then we got our staff to worry about. We have team success. We have fan happiness stuff. And marketing. All this has other things inside of it. Team popularity, medium player marketing, a whole bunch of stuff to do here. And the staff is, the part of our staff is so bad is we have Mark Trestman as our coach, and we have one of the least respected head coaches in the league, and it's hurting our value. But he's the first time coach, first year ever in the NFL. He's been a coordinator, I know, at times. He came from the Canadian Football League, so he doesn't have any respect in the league. I think that's what's really hurting us. And I don't know why our scout looks like he just got back from a Grateful Dead concert, but he does not look like an NFL scout to me. Maybe he does. I don't know. Our trainer looks pretty intense, though. Looks German or something. Okay, so that's all the stuff that we do with this team, which is really cool to me. So a lot of stuff here. And then eventually, we have a legacy leaderboard, which is the point of our stuff, is to become like the highest owner, legacy-wise. We got a 500 boost because we were a former player. So we got a little bit of the score here going in. I'm assuming I was probably an offensive lineman with my body shape or something, or maybe a defensive tackle. I don't think I was a quarterback with the way my dude looks. Okay, so let's go to action, start a league. We're going to start season. We're not going to do a fantasy draft. We're going to keep the actual players as they are. Now we have media questions. So media question one with Charles Morris. Oh wait, it's advancing. Where's our media question? Oh, there it is. So practice. Normally you could practice and get some XP, but I normally would probably do that if I wasn't recording and playing it, or I'd do it off camera. I'm not gonna do it now though. We'll just skip it. And we're gonna simulate our preseason game. Let's do our media question.
You headed up a group of investors to potentially buy an NFL franchise. Now you have one. Why'd you want to be an owner so bad?
Why do I want to be an owner so bad? Truthfully, it's the fans. Okay, my history being what it is, I think it could be unique. NFL success-driven lead. I succeeded as a player, and when I retired, I realized I wanted a new challenge, and this was it. Okay, we're gonna go fan happy here. We want to get the fans back involved. They don't like our staff. The fans are great to me as a player, and I just want to stay involved in the game and give back. All right. So our ticket prices per winning season has gone up 10%, and per losing season has gone down 15%. I'm curious what that would be if I did not pick that. I'm guessing maybe per losing season, and maybe they'd go down more than 15. We should have got a bonus because we were good to the fans. But I'm not sure about that. That's an assumption. Let's see. Buffalo wants to trade. We're not trading anybody right now. We're not trading. No. Okay, so let's advance our week. I don't know. I may not get a game in this time, this video. I really want to try to get a game in, but I like to show all this stuff too. I don't know, I think if you watch how it starts, I think it's, you feel like you're more involved maybe watching it? I don't know. I would. Who knows? Obviously, you want to skip past all this, just fast forward right to the game. We've got 4 weeks of this crap. So we're going to sim our preseason game again. Now, Progress Players is, I told them that they can do that. Basically, if you go into manually progress players, each player has their own XP amount. It's not like, you know, so this guy has 458 XP to spend, Earl Bennett. We can go in here and specifically raise, even though he doesn't have enough to do anything right now, we can raise different stats of his, and there's tons of them. And there's, you know, 53 players on your team by the time the season starts, and each guy gets XP, so it'll take a while to do it all. So that's why I'm going to skip it. I'm going to assume they'll probably do a decent job at it. So we're going to auto do it. I'll leave that. I'm the owner. I'll just leave that to my coaching staff. That's their job. My job is to get the money, you know. Middle linebacker, no, he's not bad. Cody is 52 overall. Defensive tackle, no thank you. Okay, so we get through week three here. I don't even care what our record is in preseason, because as everybody knows, preseason doesn't mean anything. You could be 0-4. I think the year the Bears went to the Super Bowl and when they played, lost to the Colts, I believe they were 0-4 that year in the preseason. They still made it. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Nobody cares. I mean, some people might care, but not most people don't care. All right, so we're just getting practice again. We're preseason gaming. I wish we could sim practice so they get a little bit more XP, but they're not. Looks like we can't do that. Auto progress, advanced week. What's interesting to me, though, actually, is that it looks like we're not cutting our guys. Maybe that's only when you're a coach that you make cuts. Oh, here's cut day. Alright, there we go. We gotta get back. Well, we start at 58, though. Usually you start earlier than that. Okay, well, our coaching staff cut. We're skipping practice again. The guys have no practice at all. Skip that, and then we'll auto-progress, so we can just get going here. So we're 0-3 in the preseason. That's not good. I'll look at the roster, actually, after this and see how the cuts went. I'm assuming... So we got $6.93 million now because we made a little bit of money on the preseason game. And I'm assuming we probably only played one preseason game. This last one must be at home because we should make more than $1.93 at two of the games. Let's see how our money goes here. Yeah, we're at 16.7 now. Yeah, we definitely made money now. We started at 5. So I do not have a draft class to import. From NCAA because I usually don't play that game, and now we have a season game, so this is it. Bengals, we're ready to go. Can we progress players before the game, or do we have to do it after the game? Oh, we do it now. Okay, all right, so let's look at our team. Our owner, we're still 14th overall. Let's look at our roster real quick and make sure that it's not completely bonkers. Okay, so we got Cutler, we got Jared Johnson, and Josh McCown. That's not exactly how they're doing it these days, but okay, that's fine. As long as we have the main guys, we got Forte and Bush, okay. We have Unga. We have Brandon Marshall, Devin Hester, Alshon Jeffrey, Earl Bennett, and Ricardo Lockett. I don't know if they're using Hester as a receiver this year that much. Or not. He's fast, but he can't catch anything. You know, he's higher rated because of his speed. Then we have Martellus Bennett, who's a pretty good tight end. Let's see, we got Bushrod on the left part of the line, which is huge. He's good for us. Slauson. Garza. Kyle Long, the rookie. And Burton. Okay, they got it right in a way because Jamarcus Webb was on this game and they cut him and now he's not on anymore. So it's not completely wrong. It's good. Cornelius Washington on the left end. Okay. And then, of course, Julius Peppers. Melton and Paya. Melton's 87 overall. He's a stud. James Anderson. DJ Williams. And the awesome Lance Briggs, 96 overall. We got Peanut Tillman, awesome, and then Tim Jennings, who had like 8 picks last year. Our safeties have always sucked a little bit in the Bears. Conte's a 75, even though they got Major Wright, he's an 84, he's not as bad as he used to be. Robbie Gould, a great kicker. Potish, he's a punter, he kicks the ball, who cares. And then Devin Hester is, of course, a 97 overall kick returner, and a 99 overall punt returner. And our third down running back should be still Forte, because he's got great hands. He plays all three downs, which is one of the great things about Matt Forte. Okay, so we're good to go. We are good to go, son. Let's lose. I expect that to probably win, but that's okay. Let's do a quick save here. Sure, I guess. Hopefully I didn't screw anything up. And we are already 17 minutes into this video. And this game is gonna be like an hour video. So this will be longer obviously than any other video because of all the stuff in the beginning. Otherwise we'll just get right to the game. So let's start it out. Season game against the Bengals at home. We are playing on All Pro. I don't think I ever mentioned that. We're only an 80. Oh, you know what? We need to put injuries back on. I don't want my guys, obviously, to get injured, but I need to at least have it. Alright, I actually lowered it a little bit. From 50 to 25 on injuries under settings here because. Where is it at? It's down here somewhere. I think I lowered it. Well, I did. Because people seem to get injured a lot, actually. Even, like, a lot in this game. It's like every game is, like, when I was messing around, just practicing how to play it. Well, or whatever, just trying it out, I guess. It seemed like people were getting hurt all the time. Like, 3 or 4 dudes a game were getting knocked out. It's a little crazy. We got the right playbooks, let's go in. So yeah, so because of that, I actually lowered the injuries down a bit. I didn't really like the fact that people get hurt as often as they were. But we are playing default, basically, all pro. I messed around, there were some, sliders up for like a more simulated type of game where you put the game speed on slow, which people do quite a bit, I think, in Madden these days, because it does run a little faster than it does in NFL. I also did the threshold between speed a little bit in favor of faster players, not a lot. What that means is that in the game, the really fast guys should be faster than the slow guys a little more than standard in the game. So, you know, Devin Hester should definitely outrun more, you know, a defensive lineman or an offensive lineman, you know, unless they get the right angle on him. Then when it's even, it doesn't really do it as much. So now that I put a little bit more, so the faster guys have a little more advantage than they should, I think. Alright, opening day.
friends, Jim Nance, along with Phil Simms. And Phil, it's the start of a whole new season. There's a sense of renewal in the air and all kinds of hope. And how do you feel about getting this season underway?
Jim, this is like Christmas, man. I go down there, open up a present. I have no idea what's inside that box. And that's what the coaches are thinking. They're not sure about their football teams. They don't know, but they're going to get some of those answers here today. And whatever happens, don't judge your whole season. I realize it's just one game. Make the corrections and move on.
Pleased to bring in the third member of our broadcast team, Danielle Bellini, with the report from the sidelines.
Thanks, guys. It's great to be here for another new season. And there's an excitement in the air today. Guys, we've got two teams looking to start week one off on the right foot. Speaking with players and coaches, there was sort of a relief that game time was finally here. Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Danielle. And now we'll go to the field.
I couldn't tell what the way the wind was if I picked the right wind. I hope I did. Usually you want the win in the fourth quarter, of course. You need a long field goal.
The Bengals are ready to return.
I don't think I picked the right wind. Usually I believe it's first and fourth is how it works with the wind. The Gold still beat the crap out of that ball.
We'll start the game at the 20. At quarterback, out of TCU, a former second-round pick, and Rose Bowl.
Okay, so
winner,
with game Andy flow, you Dalton, can pick game plan, Andy aggressive, Dalton, or conservative. And
skills.
Basically,
they like the fact that
then
an
it
thrower,
plays a call,
and
it makes a call for you.
A really good leader.
So we're going to be using game plan for this, and this, for some reason, I just start to really dislike it.
Green Ellis is lined up directly behind the quarterback here. The first week of the NFL season is underway. They've got him down there.
Ben Jarvis Green Ellis.
One of the most dynamic players in the National Football
I might
Football
let some of this
League
stuff play this first game
AJ
so you can
Green.
See how the
Jim,
presentation
you're right,
is.
He is dynamic, one of the best in the NFL, tall, fast, and can make every catch. A.J. Green is one of the best.
Yeah, A.J. Green scares me.
Jones going to get set in the slot for this snap. Second down and four. Draw play here.
Oh, come on. Make a tackle,
brought
man.
Down at the 29. Number 42. The ball carrier on the Tim Jennings of the Bears led the league in interceptions last season with 9.
Just
has
nine
a
picks.
Great knack, can read wide receivers when they're coming out of breaks and not afraid to take chances. That's why he got 9
third and
one.
Last year. Let's look for the run right, since they're stacking that way.
Andy Dalton will be under center.
Oh, he's passing.
Third and
shit.
One. Looking to the right side
oh,
and
hurt.
Throwing. Brings it into his
oh, I missed tackle. Oh, my God. We're not going good enough. Shit. I went for the big hit instead of just the regular tackle. Dumbass.
It's often the difference maker in any game, and that is how you perform inside the red
oh,
zone.
Oh, Conte.
Hold
I want,
that.
If you,
no
sl- if you
it,
use the right stick.
Get in the red zone. We'll see what the offense calls.
When right before you tackle, if you slam it toward the guy, you can actually do a big hit.
Let's
sometimes it jars the ball loose.
The big play here. They're going back up
and that's what I did.
The quarterback throws to the right.
Like that.
Green with the catch.
But he was wide open there. And
well,
I don't like our safeties.
This close, you got to be tough, big, and strong to get in the end zone. That time, he falls a couple inches short.
Not a good start for the Bears here. Kind of reminds me of the Bears game yesterday.
The
didn't look very good in the beginning, but they end up pulling it off by three.
Just outside the goal line, challenging the
where is the... Oh, my God. Nobody's over there.
Touchdown.
You know,
oh, this is not
player,
good.
And you're covering a receiver down here on first and goal. You don't have to cover that much area. That's a terrible job by the defense giving up that
wow, they just came
pass.
Down and whooped my ass. Gresham's the guy with the big catch, and then
the
you get the touchdown.
Now will have their chance to respond with their first drive.
The only thing I won't game plan is these kicks, because they game plan it when there's two guys back. And then Hester doesn't always get it. I want Hester to get the ball every time. Because of that! Right there, baby! Go! Oh, Devin! What are you? You're a madman! Oh, baby! Yes! That is why you're here, because you cannot catch. I may actually drop him down a little bit. Oh, Marvin's pissed. Oh, I'd be pissed too, Marvin. You come down and score, and I run right back on you.
It's always a risk.
Let's take a look at that.
The end zone on a kick return.
But how about this? This time,
oh, look at that blocking. Perfect. Look at that hole. You drive a truck through it.
He takes off and he says, yes, yes.
So that helps right there. Like I said, I took put the threshold up a little bit. So the faster guys are definitely faster a little bit than everybody else.
Is good.
The ratings matter a little bit more, and I think that's good because, you know, you got Devin Hester, you got
a tie game now.
These great speed guys. They should be faster. And being that I have Devin Hester actually helps a lot, obviously, you can see right there, because that could happen a few times
this
year.
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20.
All right, let's play some defense, Bears. It was embarrassing. Even though I had a terrible missed tackle, which didn't help. Last possession, but still.
Green Ellis is lined up as the single back. First down and 10.
There we go, Pia.
Hands it off on the draw. They deck him in the backfield.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
But a couple of times, though, when it looked like it might be, you know, curtains for Marvin in Cincinnati, and all he does is somehow find a way to rebuild the team.
Julius Peppers.
Seasons for the
one thing I don't like, the coaches are way off the field. Look how far off the field he is.
He would be done.
Which doesn't make any sense. Unless there's some new rule I don't know about where they can't be on the field. The coaches are usually standing right on the edge, yelling in and doing whatever they need to do. So it's a little weird to me that they have it like that.
Dalton's got it in the gun. The throw to the left, and that pass is going out.
Terrible throw by Dalton. All right. All right, we stopped the run, and he threw an incomplete pass, so that's good for us. Much better than last possession. Because of Devin, we actually are still in this game, even though they came down and scored on us so quick. And Devin's got it again. Good blocking. He has a chance again to do nothing. He has a chance to run directly into...
Here comes the man who's not afraid to throw it down
special
the field,
there.
Quarterback Jay Cutler.
Well, we all right, the Bears finally get actually their offense down on the field.
It's time to see it all come together. He has talent.
We don't need an offense with Devin.
It's time to get it done.
Hester's lined up now as a slot receiver. Quick drop back. Makes the catch. That's a tackle right near the 48. A multi-dimensional player for this Bears offense is running back Matt Forte.
Yeah, he sure is.
Matt Forte's a stud, and Brandon Marshall is the stud.
He can protect the quarterback.
So for those who don't play Madden, the red marks on the screen here is your actual play. So red is the intended guy. This is going to be a run.
Satisfies. Second and two. They feed the running back. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
And then on passing plays, that's your primary receiver. And I'll probably look his way more often than not.
The defense being too aggressive. They're over-pursuing. So you do the little counter, go the opposite
but
direction.
But if he's not open, I'll try to go somewhere else, obviously. Brandon Marshall should get a lot of balls.
Jay Cutler takes a look now from under center.
But Bennett is actually getting the calls so far.
Cutler still got the football after the play fake. He's wide open for the
Bennett
pass.
Is getting the ball because he's getting the call. And he is showing up.
Well, if you want to be a good
that was wide open.
Team,
that was a good play
it's
play
always
action.
Nice
wide
to have
open.
A good running game. Make the defense dig in.
I think
and
I could have actually made that
run.
Throw.
When they do that, you fool them. You fake it, you throw
man,
it
they got Bennett's
field.
Number
that,
again
that's,
called.
That's about as easy as it gets.
I must know something I don't.
In the shotgun ready for the snap.
But it's working. Oh, it's working. You know what? You guys just, you double and triple team Brandon Marshall.
That's
I'll just
nice
throw my tight end. He
here.
Is
get
wide
the first
open.
Down, keep those chains moving. Give yourself. Three more opportunities.
Three grabs for 45 yards in this drive alone.
That reception gave them the first down. So first and goal to go. The handoff
go.
To Matt
oh.
Forte. A linebacker for the Bengals who had a stellar rookie season. Undrafted coming into the league.
They have some good linebackers.
Yeah, how about that? Undrafted. There's so many good linebackers.
Perfect's pretty good. Even though
he
made some mistakes
football.
In the
Bengals,
game yesterday, the
great
real
job
game. But
finding,
James Harrison.
And also, become a starter,
awesome.
Did a good job.
Offense lines up here. Sect powers.
Got
his
it.
Way across. Touchdown.
That's black and blue division right there. Up the middle. Da Bears. What are you yelling about, Marvin? There you go, Trestman. Yeah. This ain't Canada anymore, buddy. You run that ball. None of this running for 10 yards behind the line for your receivers before the play and all that crap.
the Bears for the extra point kick. And the extra point is good.
All right. Good drive. Get some Gatorade there first. You would deserve it.
Bears ready to kick the football.
I'm actually happy with that drive because I tend to throw a lot of interceptions. So the fact that I, even though, smart, I mean, Bennett was open for all three of those. These coordinators know what they're doing right now because I'm just kind of following their lead. Okay, what are we going to go with? I tend to play a lot of different guys on defense, actually.
First down here.
You know, I stuck with the linemen, basically.
They give it to the running back. Gains 13.
A lot of ways that was not good on my part.
It doesn't always have to be by a pass. Good job that time by the running back.
All right, first quarter is done. 14-7, Bears. Da Bears.
15 minutes down, 45 minutes to go. And you're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Soldier Field.
The Bengals offense
like
is still out there as we get the second quarter underway.
It does look like a spaceship. For those who don't know about Soldier Field, it's a historical monument, and the field itself is. So, and there's all these pillars outside. It's an awesome looking stadium. But the thing was, they had to redo it. I think it's been 10 years or so now. They had to redo it, but because it's a historical monument, it's a monument to our armed services that they couldn't do anything with the outside. So instead of tearing anything down on the outside, they weren't allowed to. They had to basically build above it and around all the pillars. So if you go there, the pillars are still there, but they're kind of, it's hard to see them at times because this big stadium's almost all above and around them. But they actually didn't take any of that old stuff out. So it was an interesting way to do it. They had to build around it.
Now first to 10. Trying to find an open man.
Damn it.
Tackle by Charles Tillman.
AJ Green, you're a stud. Of studs. Come on, Peanut.
All day to throw like this. When you give an average quarterback this kind of time, he turns into a great.
I thought he was going to run that.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here.
Look, he had a gap to run. He decided to throw it.
He's looking to the right.
There it is, Major Wright. Oh, baby. Bears.
That was just a terrible
sausage.
Offensive player that time, protect the football.
Bears.
No excuse for letting it
Ditka.
Fumbling the football in a situation like that.
Sausage. Major Wright takes him out.
The Bears are
that's
going
the hit stick right there.
Close
that's what
game.
I tried
second
to do
quarter,
and the guy running
the
down the line earlier.
To
whiffed. They're calling Bennett's number again. This is insane.
Just a quick drop back. Looking for an open receiver.
We're going to Marshall.
Right. Gains 5.
Short little pass. Start this drive off.
Well, when you keep chipping away with
the
these
Bears
short
led
runs,
the league, I believe, in turnovers last year, but they didn't
up,
make the playoffs.
And when they come
very
up,
strange.
That's when you throw it over the top.
Jay Cutler will take the snap out of the gun. Second and 5. Looking to the right side and throw.
Alshon Jeffery.
The tackle's going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
I think the best thing to say about that play is just it gained a few yards, so that's what you do. All plays don't score. Sometimes you just want to pick up a couple yards.
They're playing a run here, it looks like.
First down, trying to
run. Sometimes when they play the run, you can get around the corner like that and get some yards. A lot of times they break through the line and kill you. That one worked out pretty good. 9 yards. Forte is running like a madman right now.
A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
Of course we can. This is the Bears, black and blue division,
Matt
baby.
Forte,
we run the ball. We run the ball
in the
here.
Forte's
oh!
The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
Nice job that time.
Get off of me.
Play gets the first down. You
that's like Peyton
chains.
Back in the
hey,
day. Just
kind of
running over people. Well, that's their linebacker they were talking about. What you got? Nothing.
To get first downs instead of throwing it all the time.
5 carries, 26 yards.
First down here after the run.
Looks like they're blitzed up the middle. So we can do a pass protection, and we're going to pinch them, I think. So they're going to block They're going to be pinched in the middle. It looks like they may be coming out the middle. Oh, they didn't.
Dropping back three. Scanning the field. Under pressure and incomplete.
Hester was open. That was a play that was actually should have been a quicker play out, but I was going to go to Marshall fast, Marshall, but it looked like they were on. They want to throw the pick.
Cutler's back in shotgun formation. He'll fire it out to the left. The Bears now move the chains.
Jeffrey!
Jim, they got momentum on their side right
Boom.
Now. They are making everything work. That was a nice play.
Look at the
they
feet. Keeps the feet in.
Down,
little stutter.
And they got a good drive going here.
So far, this has been my favorite Madden in a long time. I actually wasn't even going to get it because last year's Madden I got, and even the year before.
Play number six coming up on this drive.
And both of them I barely played for some reason. I just didn't like it. I just didn't feel that good. This one feels really good. So I think it's definitely probably the best one in a while.
Halftime, 2 minutes away.
Even though that guy just completely whipped. The little things still bother you like that. He basically sprayed Gatorade all over the dude's neck. Completely missed his mouth.
Marshall's lined up in the slot.
Looks like they're in a cover one, or it could be a cover three.
Cutler steps back into the gun. Working that left side.
Brandon Marshall.
And he'll step out of bounds.
Oh, this offense is tearing these guys apart.
The sidelines is just keep marching down the field. And picking up those first
so we're in the little
down.
Screen of Forte here. See if we can get break a little something, something.
After that catch for a first down. First and goal. Screen pass.
Oh, my Lord.
Forte has it from Cutler. As good as it gets. Touchdown.
Man, I wish I had Forte on my fantasy team right now.
Well, when the offense goes in there and scores,
what a
again,
screen, what a call. Lead, this coordinator, man, is killing it. Every call that I've made, they've jump. Made, and I've ran, it's almost been wide open so far.
The point after try.
And we are killing the Bengals. Matt Forte dominating performance early on.
Robbie Gould ready to kick it.
Besides that first drive where they came down and basically kicked their
they
ass,
will run this one back.
We've dominated. Devin Hester
and
with the run back.
Right at the 30-yard line after that return.
In all honesty, we're dominating all three phases, really, except for that first drive. Our special teams got a touchdown. Our defense got a turnover. Our offense had two possessions and both of them were touchdowns.
Green Ellis is lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. We got a flag.
My guy jumped
here.
Off sides.
The quarterback throws to the right.
They're going to decline that because they got a nice, they got a first down there. Unless they're stupid.
The penalty is declined. That last play will hold up. Gresham's move from the tight end position to the slot. Now first and 10. Looking for a receiver on the left side here. Tackle down at the 46-yard line. They get set quickly, ready for another snap. This will be second down. Tight end
right, they're calling.
Motion.
They're trying to get going here. No huddle. Yeah, clock running out.
Challenging the defenders. To
oh,
the
oh, he dropped it. Oh, what a pass.
Do one thing at a time. Catch the football. Then do the next thing, run with it. He tried to run with it too quick.
Oh, Gresham, he's the one that's been killing me. Third and two, let's go aggressive. And let's bump the receivers a little bit here. I'm assuming they're probably going to run this ball.
Andy Dalton will be under center.
So let's also go,
third and
two. Good idea to switch it to run.
To his left.
Ah, it's wide
they
open
pick up the first down with that reception.
There's an injury.
Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
That's not AJ Green, is it?
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get
is that 18?
Like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow.
Or is that 16?
The good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And
that's 16. AJ's still out there. I don't know. Actually, I was most worried it was AJ Green
was
for some
big
weird
gainer.
Reason.
Now it's time
he's
to
awesome,
back it up.
Even though I actually like him out of the game. Come on, Major. Let's get up the middle here. Let's get a blitz. Get some pressure. We haven't sacked him yet, I don't think.
First and 10. Eyeing that left side. Makes the catch inbound.
Give Dalton time to pick us apart.
Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than seven, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
Second and two. Quarterback drops back. Play action.
Damn it.
He makes the catch.
Damn it.
Touchdown. That'll
They're killing me now. All of a sudden, I was talking about how I was winning all the phases. That was like, man, everybody's wide open on that drive.
Well, that's a good touchdown by the offense there. And, you know, and what
all right, well, our offensive coordinator's killing it. Our defensive coordinator, not so much.
Confidence is a dangerous thing. We'll see if they can keep moving forward after this.
The Bears will get their hands on the football again, but their lead is not the same. Things are getting tight here. The scores 21-14.
Oh, Devin. Oh, he almost broke another one, kind of. Not really, but thought if you could have stayed on his feet for a second there, you might have had a chance. We only got a minute four left, and they're saying to go for it. Wow, look at that. All verticals, huh?
The Bears come to the line of scrimmage and empty out the backfield. Everyone split out wide.
Lock it! Oh, my God.
These receivers in the NFL, they are so good now. Anytime you see a drop pass, it's almost always the one reason. They took their eyes off the football before
that,
he got to
it. Yeah, he was wide open down the middle. He might not have scored, but he would have made it. He would have got by. Probably at least midfield.
Second down and 10.
Oh, I'm in trouble.
And he's prone to
Damn
the
it.
Ground. The Bengals are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
I got lost there. I actually forgot who my primary was.
The Bears have to get to the 33 for a first.
Damn it.
It's a two tight end formation. Matt Forte taking it up the middle. No surprise. They immediately call the timeout.
I'm not going to throw a pick down here. I'm going to let them dip and earn this.
Should be
I try to play football the right way. I'm going to boot it down, get them to probably get the ball around midfield, though, which is still an awesome field position.
Tate now with the return. Gains nine.
Yep. But they got to earn these 20 yards for a field goal.
Jones is going to get set in the slot for this snap. First down and 10. Dalton looking long.
Major right. Catch the ball, you mother. Oh, my gosh. Oh, he had that.
Uses his hands, and once they go up, put your hand in between them and knock that football down. What a play.
Second down and 10. That catch gives them a first down.
Ball! Oh, I got it back.
Wasting little time. Under 2 minutes to go in the half, and that means we've got a booth review.
Why are they reviewing this? They got the ball anyway.
Well, it was called one way on the field, but now inside.
I knew it wasn't
minutes,
a fumble. I felt it wasn't a fumble even when it happened.
The ball was overturned.
I think if you left it up to the coaches, they'd like the booth to review them all, Jim, because put all the pressure on the officials in the NFL. That's what it's there for, to overturn.
Wow. Oh, my God. AJ Green.
Touchdown.
Holy cow. Bengals are actually supposed to be pretty good this year. They made the playoffs the last 2 years. But wow, their offense is killing me now.
Good job by the offense. They get in there. They tie this game up. Now we'll see if the defense can take advantage of that momentum and keep it on their side.
Count it. The Bengals going to be kicking it away now. Their offense took control with a very
wow.
good starting
AJ
field
Green,
position.
Man.
Following the very
he just went
punt.
Right down the
and
seam.
They made sure not to squander
me.
That opportunity and put points on the board. Exactly what you have to do in those situations. The Bears.
All right.
Getting ready
they're saying
to
just run out
drive.
To halftime, huh?
Jay Cutler takes a look now from under center. First and 10. The handoff to Matt
Which
Forte.
Is the right call, actually. You know what? I'm calling a timeout.
Signal for the timeout. And that's the first one they
used.
Yeah,
they're going verticals now. We got a little bit of yardage. It's worth giving a shot. If we can get to the 30, we got the win behind our back, I'm pretty sure.
Lined up in the backfield. Second down and two. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
Oh, Brandon.
That one to knock it away.
Oh, good job by the linebacker.
Yeah, he was like,
passed down that time.
Yeah,
all he
was
did
covered.
Was watch the eyes of the quarterback, and it reacted. It
I know I said I like to play real football, but football I called that timeout, and the coordinators are calling these plays.
Snap, and we'll head to halftime. Third down and two. Jay Cutler with the deep ball. A takeaway.
Yep, it was picked.
Steps out of bounds.
One pick from
Cutler
now. And
with the second
now.
Quarter coming to a close, we'll step away for halftime and return to the Windy City for the start of the second half after this. Which is brought to you by Verizon. Danielle's got an update from the sidelines. Let's go to her now. Danny?
I caught up with Coach Trestman during halftime.
All right.
Tie ball game here, guys. And Coach told me the second half is going to be.
And every time I call it, pick the other way.
As a coach, you never know which play they might be, but it always comes down to a couple plays here or there. And he just hopes his team will be on the right side of those plays. Guys, back to you.
Danielle, thank you very much. Now we'll go to the field. Marshall's lined up now as a slot receiver. Looking for an open receiver on the right.
They haven't fixed that yet since, like, the first Madden. I hate that. You throw these plays at the sidelines,
and
he keeps running out of bounds. Unless I just have to throw it differently.
So they complete that one, yet it's still second down. Cutler's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
Oh, that was terrible.
Got a hand on it, and it's incomplete.
Fuck.
Oh, nice job. That cornerback. He was watching the quarterback. He's all over the receiver.
I usually watch on those curls. I usually watch the linebacker to see if he's drifted over, and I actually didn't really watch him.
Failing to connect there.
And he drifted over.
Jay Cutler from the shotgun. He's looking long.
Oh, what a catch!
Amazing catch.
Well, one of the prettiest plays Bet in the NFL, maybe in all of sports. It's still the long pass down the field that is completed. What a nice throw catch.
Oh my God! I gotta watch that. I wasn't looking at Bennett until the last second. Right here, I saw he was right there. I saw he was open. But by the time I got the ball to him, I should have thrown it to the right a little bit. Glad I would have kept it away from the safety. I just threw it. See, yeah, if I would have threw it to the right, aimed it right a little, he'd been wide open easy. But he's still. Whoa! Left hand grab, one handed. Wow. Yeah, man, if I would have just tossed it a little bit to the right, he probably would have almost, he might not have touched down there.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play.
Damn it.
And they bring him down at the 36-yard line.
Man, Nelson has seven tackles.
1 yard gain on the play.
I was about to say, we can't get rid of, can't forget Forte out here.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Cutler is going to take it from the gun.
They're giving Bennett. This whole game is designed for Bennett right now. He's wide open. He just had that huge play. He got another one there. Grab. The man is a stud. It's his call again. Look at this.
Hester's in the slot. Now first and 10. Play action fake. Looking to throw.
Oh, that's not good. Damn it, I thought I'd be able to get out of bounds.
Behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, if your offensive line's not good enough just to stop the pass rush, then you got to help them out. How do you do that? Well, you keep the tight end in, let him be an extra blocker, and you tell your running backs to help out, too, blocking some of these defensive linemen.
That draw didn't work.
Behind the line.
That time, I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision, and it cost his team yards lost.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Cutler's got it in the gun. Looking to the right side and throwing. He's brought down. That's going to bring
I'm surprised that did not get intercepted. I gunned that in to Hester.
There's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first down.
Didn't get enough for the first, though.
Robbie Gold,
we got to kick the field goal and take the lead. I know we got the win. We're into the win. I have no idea what's going on with the win right now.
He converts here on the field goal try.
Gotta take the lead.
That was a good hold, good kick, 3 points. Good job by the offense.
Apparently it's not first and fourth. I thought it was first and fourth. I've always been confused on the win.
It's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. The Bengals get ready to start their drive. Now on first down. Here's the quick toss. Throws the stiff arm.
I saw there that so many. It's obvious they're going right at that time. And moved the shift the defensive line to the right a little bit. And they're definitely going. And they're pretty much doing the same thing here. But this looks like a pass.
Coming up, second down. Action fake. Throwing now to his left. Forgot to catch the football.
You gotta catch that.
Really simple. Keep your eyes on the football. When
gotta
not
catch
on
that,
it,
son.
That's when you drop it, and that's what happened that time.
Jones, a receiver in the slot. Third and 8.
Let's get some pressure on this guy.
Throws to the right.
He has all day. All day. Is he even dirty?
Well, when you get time in the pocket against cover three, it's easy to see down the field towards the sidelines, and you get easy completions just like that last one.
I guess I should have went aggressive there to try to get some pressure on him, but
catch.
I don't want to screw up, leave somebody wide open when there's someone wide open anyway. Another drop. These guys cannot catch, and we're losing
the receiver. When they drop footballs, usually it's because you can see their head move the other way before the football gets there.
We're not losing them, actually, but I feel like we are almost.
And it's a drop pass.
Dalton will take it from the gun.
Washington just fell on his butt. This guy's wide open again. AJ Green is absolutely killing me.
When you're behind in a football game, all you can do on the offensive side is just go out there and thinking about making plays.
Oh, my God. He's at 7 for 129 already in the third quarter.
First down following the long play.
Oh, he caught that.
The pass. The Bengals now move the chains. This is turning into quite a drive, Phil.
Nice job, Jim, by the offensive coordinator, just mixing the plays up and keeping the defense off balance.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Quarterback, quick toss to the outside.
Oh, what's a pop.
Behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense.
You can stay down there, dude. Seriously, it's all right.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Tackle down at the 22.
Fuck. They're killing me, man.
The Bengals have to get to the 17-yard line for a first down.
AJ Green is just dominating. He should, actually.
The NFL on EA Sports.
Because he is a stud.
The Bengals offense tries to continue some momentum, still possessing the football as the final quarter gets underway.
I think we're missing Urlacher here.
Jones lined up in the slot to the ground here.
I had a feeling I'd call that like a conservative beat, and I had a big zone going on, and I saw that line. I'm like, I'm probably gonna draw.
Jim, when you get inside the other team's red zone, inside
and usually
the 20-yard line,
that'll work
down,
if the defense
points,
is playing that conservative.
You're thinking touchdown in these situations.
Nice tackle there. Oh, Paya. Miss it. Nope. Hard.
The field goal try. Yes, sir.
Ted Nugent.
Well, when you get points, it's never a bad
thing. Oh, I kicked
thing.
I used the wrong
sure.
thing.
The
please, Hester, catch the ball.
Nice
Thank
job
you.
By the offense moving the football down.
Hester
the field.
Will always run the ball out. I don't care where it got kicked to. Oh, one more quick little turn left. I might have had it.
Down at the 23.
Sorry, we got back to the 20. Past the 20. So it's better than a touchback.
They face first down. Cutler standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap.
Brandon Marshall, pick off. Damn it!
Runs out of bounds. What a play! Snickers is the proud sponsor of this satisfying defensive.
Throw the ball, man. He had a step on him.
Snickers satisfies.
Good job that time by the defense, not being fooled.
two picks.
Position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That
he had
did,
a step on him.
The interception.
First down.
And it did nothing for us.
Ben Jarvis, Green Evans, carries
well, I didn't
the ball.
Hit up when I threw it. Maybe I had to hit up. Lead him a little bit more. I just kind of tapped
deep.
Throw the lob.
Resistance. They're not running the football very well today. And that time,
I mean, he had single coverage. If you have Brandon Marshall with single coverage, you have to throw the ball
Green
to him.
Ellis is in the backfield. Second down and seven. Dalton's play action. Reaches out and snatches it.
Even though that got picked off, I do it every single time.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked.
You can
much,
tell he is going to have single.
There gets another
so.
Completion.
First down here after the completion as they go ground here.
He's only averaging 3.5 yards a carry, which is not bad. Actually, he's got the ball 10 times. But it's not terrible.
Green Evans is lined up behind his quarterback as the
single problem back. Is pick Peanut! Peanut Tillman!
No
yes. Oh, Peanut!
The 10. Touchdown!
Oh!
This satisfying defensive replay.
That is, you do not throw the ball like that to Peter Tillman.
Hungry for victory, Snickers satisfied.
Well, you're behind in the game. You're figuring, how are we going to get this done?
Oh, Peanut! They went to that tight end again.
Defense gets the turnover, takes it back for a touchdown. My gosh, that will, if that doesn't spur the team on to the victory, I don't know what can.
And the point after is good.
This is the Bears, man. This is how the Bears are in real life. Have trouble on the offensive side of the ball. Even though we did have two
the Bengals are
offensive
to
touchdowns in the first
kick.
Half. But now I'm throwing picks. The defense, we have a special teams touchdown from Hester.
Ran the tape with a
we have a defensive
to
touchdown and turnovers from our defense. That's how the Bears are.
It was well covered by
it's always a what the hell, just
the
complete chaos.
For their next possession. Jones is going to get set in the slot for this snap. First and 10. This is a screen play all the way.
I was wondering why I was getting in, with, I was in his face with.
Stats. So he throws that short pass, picks up a couple yards.
I was totally in his face there with Peppers. That's because they were doing a screen and completely, completely faked me out.
Andy Dalton in the shotgun.
Come on, Julius.
Formation. The Bengals get a first down.
God, we don't have one sack this whole game. It's terrible.
He knows it's zone, and he's going to find the open throwing lane, and he gets it done.
That reception gave them the first down. Dalton's back in shotgun formation. And the throw
wow.
is
that was a bad throw.
This
he hasn't thrown many bad ones.
There's no doubt
that
about
pick
it.
Was
they
bad,
did
obviously.
This time,
but overall, he hasn't thrown a lot of terrible
balls. Jones is in the slot. Dalton's going to take the snap from the
yeah,
shotgun.
Washington's got pancakes.
Looking to the right side and throwing. Makes the reception.
Number 15 completes the pass.
Nice job by the quarterback finding the open guy short. They get the completion. They still do not get the first down, though.
It'll be
I'm gonna
play
down. The run more, but I'm kind of nervous.
Ben Jarvis, oh, Green Ellis yep. will run with it. That's been the story of this game. Another third down conversion to move the chains.
Well, that's just a good
I put
old
run middle to
kind of. And
it's good figure
for
they're
going to
kind of go that route,
down.
But I still can't stop them.
Dalton will take it from the gun. The quarterback throws.
What
to
a
the
catch!
Right. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Jeez!
Good job by the receiver running into that defense, through the zone, finding the open space and making a nice catch.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. Dalton's going to take it from the gun. Challenging the defenders
no
to
way.
The right side did not get both feet down.
Well, Jim, I can't say that's great defense. That's just a poor throw and a poor route run by the wide receiver.
Time is running out. The defense knows it's playing with the lead, but doing whatever it can to just try to run out the clock. Had it, but dropped it.
Not much the offense can do in a situation like this. third and long, what you probably will have to do
334
is surprise them with the run,
three touchdowns,
or throw it short,
but one pick, and that pick was huge.
Dalton's got it in the gun, trying to work that left
wide
side.
Open. Oh my God!
Another first down on third.
What a nice catch. I'm blitzing, and I still can't get to him.
The yard markers, makes the catch and gets a first down.
Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment.
Our pass rush wasn't that good yesterday in the actual Bears game either. It's showing here.
This drive now about to reach the 10th play of the series.
All day, all day.
And it's out of bounds, incomplete.
Coverage. That was good coverage, apparently, because he threw the ball away. He had all day just to stay in there. I mean, you need your front four to actually do something sometimes.
Second and 10. He's looking to the right here on this throw. And that
no.
pass is going
oh.
out of bounds, incomplete.
The defense has really done a good job here.
And the Bears had those great defenses. Their front four was able to get pressure without
situation.
Blitzing.
Let's see if they can convert it.
The Giants are the same way. They have those, you know, good defense a few years ago. Strahan, Tucker, they get pressure without blitzing. We have not been able to do that.
Short of the first,
and that's killed us.
Bring up fourth down, marching down the field and taking their time. They send the tight end in motion. He'll fire it out to the left.
Yes! Jennings knocks it down. Oh, thank you.
Why would you go for it on fourth down in this situation? You don't get
no,
it.
No, I'm not passing it. Go to game. Okay. Oh. I was on pass for some crazy reason.
Still a very
I mean, there's
close
no way there.
The
if this
quarter,
is going a straight game plan,
they're going to
tell me to pass.
31 to 24. First down and 10. Forte's going to take the handoff now.
Dance.
The Bengals are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
We're going to call. We're going to have them burn timeouts. That's all we can do here. Burn timeouts, buddies. Even if they get the ball back, they'll have no timeouts left.
That's
one first down, this game's
up.
Over. Let's get it on the ground.
Matt Forte gets it.
Let's
in.
Not get it on the Stop ground. Right Holy there. Shit. Yes. Wow. I'm surprised he got up from that hit. I'm surprised he didn't fumble.
Jay Cutler takes a look now from under center. Third and 9. Matt Forte.
Oh!
Solid tackle. Short of the first. And now we've got a fourth down situation.
It's all right. He had a little bit of hole there. I just couldn't get there through it fast enough. They wasted all their timeouts.
Third down, and they come up short of a first. And they'll call on the punter. Tate now with a return. Good yardage picked up on that call.
Oh, that wasn't terrible, I guess, considering.
The Bengals are ready to take over now, and their offense heads onto the field. Jones, a receiver in the slot. First and 10. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Going to be a penalty here.
Holden. Holding. Marvin's pissed. It's got to be a hold. Is that a hold on AJ Green?
Personal foul. Clipping.
Whoa! Personal clipping call on AJ Green? 15 yards?
Well, contact around the knees, and they flagged them for the clipping call.
Yes, please.
They did. It was a good call.
Actually, I'm curious if they actually show him clip. AJ should be on the right side normally, right? Yeah, there he is. He didn't obviously catch the ball, so he blocked. Oh, that is a block in the back, though. It's not really a clip. But it's definitely a block in the back, so at least he did kind of do something wrong. I wouldn't have called it a clip.
You hold your breath when you see plays like that. You just hope somebody doesn't get hurt.
First down following the penalty. Tight ends in motion here. Andy Dalton in the shotgun formation.
Wow, he, wow.
You are not going to be an accurate quarterback, of course, when you're under this kind of pressure. Doesn't even have time to set his feet. Another throw offline.
Apparently he was under pressure there. I didn't see it.
The Bengals head to the line and out of timeout.
There we go. There we go. Get him. Oh, my God. Sack him. What are you doing?
In these type of situations, when you're losing the game, it's third and long. Don't try to be a hero because
he was right there. Sorry, he's replays. I mean, he was right there. And he, like, missed. He just missed. That's major right, right? It's got, yeah, that was a safety blitz. No, is that major right? How do I zoom? Zoom X. No, Hayden. Oh, he's probably my nickelback. Where are you going? Where are you going? Tackle him. That's game. Well,
it's going to lead to a turnover. Then you really will be.
It's probably game, right? Because he's The clock could at least be running. Then he complete pass, stop the clock.
Quarterback taking the snap from the shotgun. Good throw and good catch right on the sideline.
All right, they got half of it back.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
The coach is going to go for it. Green's lined up in the slot. Dalton standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Looks around.
Get him! Get him! Yes!
Turn it over on downs.
Finally!
The quarterback to throw the football that time. The offensive line did their job, but
first sack of the game. Couldn't come at a better time.
They are covered all over the field.
And now we can QB kneel and win this game. That's what I'm going to do. I'm just winning this game.
They bring in the extra tight end.
Two kneels will do it. 40-second clock, right? Yeah. Over. Oh, that was an intense game by these Bears. Wow.
The defense comes out in the nickel, takes the knee.
And we got the win somehow. Somehow we won that game. We had a kick return, we had an interception return for a touchdown. That's how we won the game. They give 300-something yards to freaking Dalton, though. Not a good defensive performance in that regard. And we had one sack the whole game, but it was at least it was at the end, and it mattered.
There it is.
They all mattered, but that didn't really matter.
The game has come to an end. It was a good one throughout.
We got achievements for something.
Right down to the wire. Nothing like winning that opening game of the season, Phil.
It really is, Jim, winning week one in the NFL.
Oh, my Lord. That was intense.
You put it out in the field. You're not sure what your team is going to do.
Yeah, Peanut, Tim, man. You didn't really shut down A.J. Green, though, Peanut, that's for sure. He had, what, 8-9 catches, probably? He had 7, for sure. I don't remember if he had any after that. Marvin Lewis cannot be happy.
GMC never say never moment
that,
of the game.
That's the play of the game?
Play stood out above the rest.
Wait, what? A 30-something yard field goal was better. A 30-yard field goal. Well, that's the owner. He's on the field. Where's my fat ass? So, like, a 30-yard field goal was more important than the interception return or the kick return or the anything else that happened? Apparently. Maybe that was the play that gave us the lead at the time. That's probably why they had that. Alright. Nice. Let's do a quick recap. To see what happened on our side, well, both sides, I guess. Alright, so we didn't do much offensively. Sorry, I heard a noise. They had 420, that's awesome. 272. I don't care more about player stats, though. Okay, so Keller had a 72 rating, not that great. He was cold, though, according to that. One touchdown, that one pick down to Marshall hurt him. But, like I said, I throw that ball every time. Marshall's single coverage. Forte, 48 yards in the end with a touchdown. 3.6 average, not that great, but not terrible. Bennett, 5 catches. He was our stud. Forte had the other touchdown when he was throwing the ball. Why is everybody cold? Everybody in the damn team's cold. They got a cold symbol by them. Defensively, Major Wright with 9 tackles. DJ Williams with 5. Peanut with 3. And that interception pick for a touchdown. And then Robbie Gould's 136-yard field goal play of the game. But okay. And I'm sure Dalton had a nice rating. Yeah, he threw for 367. 3 touchdowns, but 1 huge interception that came all the way back for a touchdown on our end. Ben Jarvis had a 3.7 average as well. And AJ had only a 7. He had 7 pretty early, if I remember. He didn't get the ball after that. All right, cool. Well, thanks everybody for watching. We're going to quit the game, and we're going to end this long video. The rest of the videos will just be the games themselves, unless something important happens that I'm recording at the time. But, so, yeah, most of these aren't going to be over an hour long. But because of the way we started the video and I showed off kind of how everything is this year, it's going to be a longer video. So, anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll see you all later. Take care.